Hello to all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am here again with my second topic of posteriology, that is classification of bone. And one thing, if you are liking my video, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Especially don't forget to turn this red subscribe button into the gray subscribe button. So on the topic of classification of the bone, we can classify the bone on the four bases, that is according to shape, structural classification, reasoning classification and developmental classification. So without wasting any time, we will start with the according to shape. Our first category, that is according to shape, there are five more further categories, that is long bone, short bone, flat bone, irregular bone and small bone. Long bones are those bones that have more length in comparison with the width. It have two epiphyses. It has two epiphyseal end with one long shaft, that is diaphysis. And the example of the long bones are how are you, fat, two foot, humerus, radius, ulna, tibia, femur, fibula. While in the short bone there will be only one epiphysis, that is there will be only one extended end and one diaphysis, that is shaft. Example of short bones are carpal and tarsal. Carpal is bone of our wrist bone, while the tarsal is bone of our ankle. If you will touch here hardly, you will see that it has only one extended end and one diaphysis. So this is our carpal bone. Flat bone. Flat bones are those bones which are compressed like the papers. And the example of the flat bones is sternum, ribs and scapula. As you can see the diagram of the scapula here, it is compressed like paper. And irregular bone. Irregular bone are those bones which do not resemble other of the four categories. They don't have any specific, any particular shape, so you can categorize them into. Example of the irregular bones are vertebrae as well as hip bone. Vertebrae, I draw the first cervical vertebrae. And last but not the least, that is sesamoid bone. Sesamoid bone, that it is present in the tendon. So why sesamoid bones are present in the tendon? What is the need of them to present inside the tendon? Because as you know that we have a muscle in our thigh, that is quadratus femoris. This is our muscle, quadratus femoris. This is femur, our bone, and this is tibia. Here, this is tendon of the quadratus femoris, because our thigh muscle, quadratus femoris, have that much power that it can sometimes torn off tibia. So for managing the pressure, for reducing the pressure, sesamoid bone is present inside the tendon. And as you know that our patella, tendon of quadratus femoris, is present in the patella. So patella have to move like this. So there must be something which can resist its pressure. So for the resistance of the pressure, we have synovial bursa or synovial fluid. It also acts as in altering the direction of pull of the muscle. So now we will move to our second category. We have developmental classification. What basically developmental classification is? It is the form of the bone from the fetal, form of development of the bone from the fetal stage to the developmental stage. Basically, it is of two types, that is intramembranous ossification and endochondral ossification. There is also a third type, membranocartilaginous ossification, but we have to give our main focus to both of them, intramembranous and endochondral ossification. Intramembranous ossification is that kind of ossification in which there will be mesenchymal condensation. So the mesenchymal membrane will directly convert into the bone with the help of mesenchymal condensation. And the examples are skull of the bone and facial bones. While in the endochondral ossification, there is replacement of the hyaline cartilage with the epiphyseal plate. Now there is cartilaginous ossification, and there will be replacement of the hyaline cartilage into the epiphyseal plate, and then it will grow in the length. Example of the endochondral ossification is bone of the limbs, vertebral column and thoracic cage. Now moving to the third category, that is membranocartilaginous ossification, in which there is partly ossification of the membrane. On the other hand, there will be partly ossification of the cartilage. We have example, clavicle, mandible, occipital, temporal and sphenoid. Now we are moving to our third category, that is regional classification. Classification and structural classification. Regional classification is simplest type of classification because we have only two regions, axial region and appendicular region. Above the pelvic girdle, everything comes under the axial region, and below the pelvic girdle, everything comes under the appendicular region. Now moving on to the structural classification, we have two type of classification, that is macroscopic and microscopic. They are further divided in some other categories. In macroscopic classification, we have two differentiating categories, that is compact bone and spongy bone. Compact bones are present in the shaft of the long bone or diaphysis of long bone, while the spongy bones are present at the two extended ends in the epiphysis. Compact bones are arranged according to the Havasian system, while the spongy bones don't have any particular kind of system. They are arranged in meshwork. While the compact bone are yellow, but after the attainment of the puberty, before the puberty, they will be red. Yellow bone marrow store the fat. As you know earlier, in spongy bone, there will be presence of the red bone marrow at the epiphyseal side because they produce RBC, WBC and platelets. Compact bones are hard in nature like ivory, while the spongy bones are spongy and soft in nature. Further moving to the microscopic classification, they are further divided into the five more categories, that is lamella, woven, fibrous, cementum and dentin. We don't have to go in much deep in this, but I can give you an overview about all these. Lamellar bone are the mature bone, woven bone are the immature bone, are the fetal bone, fibrous bones are mature fetal bone, cementum and dentine, they both come under our tooth. You may know this. Cementum bones are the main supportive bones for our tooth, while the dentine covers the surface of the cementum. So now we completed our classification of the bone and the types of classification. In our next lecture, we will study about the gross structure of a long bone. And for any more queries, you can also DM me on my Instagram ID for any query. Thanks for watching.